Hello everyone, iSchool Tech here. Now, iOS 17.1 just released to everyone, bringing some new features and changes as well as plenty of bug fixes. Now, in this video, I'm going to be taking a look to see how iOS 17.1 is going to perform on your iPhone. Anyways, if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more content just like this, and let's get straight into the video. So starting off with the performance, there is absolutely zero change coming from either every other version of iOS 17. Now, I haven't come across a task that iOS 17.1 could not handle, so the lack of change here isn't particularly a bad thing. However, the iPhone does feel much snappier on iOS 17.1, as Apple has fixed some stuttering issues that previous iOS 17 releases were affected by. Now, iOS 17.1 is very, very, very smooth, and it's a noticeable improvement over iOS 17.0.3 for me. I'm very happy to see this. Now, as far as things like RAM management, iOS 17 performs great with keeping apps open in the background for extended periods of time. Now, I've noticed pretty much zero app reloads after having apps idle in the background for an extended period of time, and I'm thoroughly impressed. However, this is not exclusive to iOS 17.1, as earlier iOS 17 releases also performed this way. Alright, so let's go ahead and run a Geekbench test on iOS 17.1. So I won't make you guys sit here and watch this. I will come back right back when it has finished. Alrighty, so here are our results. You can see we get a 2650 for a single core and a 6933 for multi-core. Now if we go ahead and compare that to our previous run on iOS 17.0, you can see that it is roughly the exact same with no significant change. Of course, these scores are slightly higher, but in real life, day-to-day usage, this will be negligible. So as far as battery life is concerned, I have noticed minimal change. However, I do notice occasionally that I will end the day off with slightly more battery life on iOS 17.1 than I did with previous iOS 17 releases. But this improvement, if you can call it that, is pretty tame and borderline negligible. Now, with this said, I still have no issue getting through the day with extra battery to spare. Now, furthermore, overheating has been virtually non-existent with iOS 17.1 for me, and we're to the point I haven't had any iPhone get too warm on me, that is, if any of them actually have. This is great to see, and I hope it continues this way. Now, of course, just to note, as soon as you update to an iOS release, it is likely that you will experience some overheating and some battery drain. This is completely normal after updating iOS and should go away on its own within a day or two. This is due to a process where the iPhone will index all of the files in the file system, which means getting them organized and trashing any unused cached files. So again, there may be slight overheating and battery drain as soon as you finish updating, but it will resolve on its own within a couple of days. Now, iOS 17.1 fixes some issues that users were having with previous iOS 17 releases. First, it fixes an issue where significant location settings may reset when transferring or pairing an Apple Watch for the first time, resolves an issue where incoming caller names may not appear when on another call, addresses an issue where custom and purchased ringtones may not appear as options in settings, fixes an issue where the keyboard may be less responsive, and addresses a pretty serious issue where some users would experience image persistence. However, there are still two issues that iOS 17.1 does not address that have been here for quite a while since early iOS 16. And now you've probably seen the first one, especially since I have reported on it and so have a few others. The notification center animations are completely glitched out and it's quite annoying to see. Now you can see this with or without notifications. For example, here with the no older notification settings, you can see it just jumps all over the place. A really glitchy animation, and I'm not sure why this hasn't been addressed. The second issue is in the control center. Now, when opening the control center or interacting with it in pretty much any way, you can see here that the actual home controls kind of disappear and then reappear. This doesn't happen in iPadOS, so I'm not sure why it happens in iOS, but this has not been fixed for quite a while as well. So even though they aren't major issues that impact usage at all, they do kind of kill the quality of life of iOS a little bit, and I hope to see these fixed in a future update, but I'm starting to have my doubts. All right, everyone. So iOS 17.1 truly is one of the most stable iOS releases in a very long time. My experience with earlier versions of iOS 17 were that it was almost, if not as stable as iOS 14, and that is really good, so much better than iOS 16. But with the addition of some new features and changes, as well as improvements and other fixes, iOS 17.1 could easily be the best iOS update that has been released in a very long time. So this is why I'd recommend that you do update, especially if you're on an earlier version of iOS 17. If you're still on iOS 16 and you're just holding out a little bit longer, I'd say that now is a pretty good time to update. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.